everyone, Ariel Adams here with blogtoread.com. Please subscribe to blogtoread videos on YouTube and like this video if you find it useful. This is a review of the Victorinox Swiss Army Night Vision. This isn't the first Night Vision, but this is the most recent version of the Night Vision. Oh, it's interesting, right here, over one of the lights, let me see if it can focus on there, it says Night Vision, and then over here on the dial says Time Vision, which I think is kind of funny. And that's because this one, the Time Vision, is where the light is to illuminate the dial, and this one is actually an LED light that is used as a little flashlight. There's a couple functions that this watch has. It's pretty interesting. Let's not talk about the lights for a second. Just the watch itself is, I think it's 42 millimeters wide, maybe 43 millimeters wide. You know, just attractive looking Swiss quartz, Swiss Army watch. I haven't had an opportunity yet to size the bracelet, but I will. You know, just nice looking conservative watch. Has the military time indicators on there. You have the date. I like that there are applied hour markers, illuminant. Just, you know, an attractive watch, and it comes in a few dials. This is the gray dial version. There's a white dial. And I like that this watch finally comes with a metal bracelet. I think I'm not sure if it did in the past, but it came with straps in the past. So this is a much more sort of, I guess you could say, formal version of this watch. So let's talk about this Ronda movement and the lighting part of it. I believe that there are two batteries in this watch. One battery is for the timekeeping mechanism, and the other battery is for the lights. The problem with this watch, I don't want to call it a problem, excuse me, is that it's not rechargeable. You have to replace the battery. So the light can use a lot of battery, and you're going to have to change it yourself, and you'd have to basically unscrew the back here to change the battery. If you have the tool, it's very easy, but there isn't one of those, like, quick change sort of like backs, you know, like with, you could use like a coin or a screwdriver. You need that special case back removal tool, which are easy to find. The good news is the battery itself is like one of those basic batteries about this big. You found a lot of calculators. You can buy them at drugstores and things like that, so they're easy to find. But watches from brands like MTM, for example, that have lights, you know, you can recharge them on a base. So that's something that's missing. But if you use it, you know, every once in a while, not every single day, you should probably get several years of use out of, at least a year, out of the lighting part. And there is an end-of-life indicator. So right there at 6 o'clock, there's actually a small red light, which actually blinks, I think, every once in a while, but will also blink rapidly or something like that when the battery is about to die. So it says locator, it says light, it says EOL, which means end-of-life for the battery. So you know what I'm going to try to do right now? I'm going to try to turn off some of the lights, actually, here around my little setup, so that I can show you some of these lights in action, because if all the lights are on, you're not gonna be able to see everything that's going on. Okay, that should be, I guess, dark enough. So there's a couple lights I'm gonna show you, not all the functions. First is just the one that lights up the dial. There's that blue LED light, which really fantastically lights up the dial. Let me even turn off another light here. Oh, went off. And you can see that's relatively bright. Beautifully lights up the dial, easy to read, not a problem at all, perfect. Then you have the light at the top. I turned on the strobe version. So this is the strobe version of it. And the way it's done with this pusher here, and you have to push it a couple times. So one time is just the basic light, and then two times would be the light at the top. So there you go. And that's relatively bright. It's not the brightest light in the world, but if you're looking for something on the ground, or you're trying to illuminate a perfectly dark area, then that's gonna do it for you. So those are the two basic lights, and then there's this red light here. You have to push them kind of rapidly. Like, turn the strobe on again. I guess this is good if you're like trying to hail down people. But basically, the two lights you're basically going to use are this one on the dial, and then the light over here to basically see things in front of you. I mean, the chances of using the strobe are, you know, other than for fun, probably not going to be that useful. Just showing you again how well it illuminates the dial there. Every single part of the dial you can read. And then you can see that. It's pretty bright. I'm actually impressed at how bright it is. Again, it's not like, you know, a crazy flashlight, but it's cool to always have on your wrist as a flashlight. Let me turn a light back on here. Actually, I don't know in the video how light or dark that is. It's probably a little bit of noise going on. we'll turn just that one on. Anyways, again, this is the Victorinox Swiss Army Night Vision. This is the newest model for 2012 on the steel metal bracelet. Very attractive watch. Cool functionality. I really like it. And the retail price is $695. You can see the full review on blogtory.com. Thanks.